Okay, so almost everybody picking, the bulk of you picking B, which has the same force by the Earth. Because the force by the Earth is just the weight, just equal to mg. The mass times g is the gravitational field of the Earth at the surface of the Earth. So g is 10 newtons per kilogram. If you're below equilibrium, then you stretch the spring, and it's going to pull harder. And the net force is going to be back toward equilibrium, in other words, upward, because it's a restoring force, or because the force by the spring is, in fact, now larger than the force by the Earth. Any questions about that one? So a bunch of math here, but I don't think anything that you can't straighten out on your own time when you feel like it. Suppose I rock this ring here out of equilibrium, and what I did there in the picture is that I've rocked it counterclockwise a little bit. So that's a little like that. And if you rock it counterclockwise, then the fulcrum is up here on the left. So it has some forces that I don't know what they are necessarily. But if I take that point as my pivot point, which it really is, so it's not a bad thing to take as a pivot point. It really is where the ring pivots. If I take that as the pivot point, then the force by the Earth acting at the center of mass is trying to rotate that thing clockwise around the pivot point. So when I rotate it counterclockwise, you see that there is a clockwise torque. And if you go through the math on this, okay, so how would you do this? Well, the rate of change of the angular momentum is just equal to the net torque. The net torque is just the force by the Earth, so that's the mass of the hoop times g, and the r vector is the radius, because the pivot point is up here on the edge. The force by the Earth is applied at the center of mass, and so that distance there is r, and then there's that sine theta that's the angle between the two. So this is the torque to the left. And dl dt, the rate of change of the angular momentum, well, a hoop, I looked it up, a hoop has, it's not hard to figure it out, but anyway, a hoop has a rotational inertia of 2 times the mass of the hoop times r squared if the pivot point is up here at the edge. And then dl dt means, well, just take the derivative of omega. So this would be I times the derivative of omega, and I times omega is L, and so the time derivative of L is I times the time derivative of omega, which is the second derivative with respect to time of theta. And so if you write that out, here's Newton's second law for rotational motion. You could just write it down, and you find out that the second derivative is proportional to some constant. The constant here is the gravitational field of the Earth divided by twice the radius. So proportional to some constant times the angle itself. The second derivative with respect to time is proportional, with respect to time of this angle, is proportional to the angle. Mass on a spring, same thing. Second derivative of the height, take two derivatives of y with respect to time, and you get the left side. That's equal to the negative of some constant times y again. So if you remember earlier, we had an exponential function whenever we had the derivative of some function proportional to the function itself. This one is not the derivative. This is actually the second derivative of some function is proportional to the function itself. The second derivative of y is proportional to y. In this, for the hoop, the second derivative of the angle is proportional to that angle. So I may have already answered this one too, but I'm going to ask it of you anyway. Newton's second law tells us that for a hanging mass spring system, the height multiplied by a negative constant is equal to the second time derivative of the height. So if I knew how the height depended on time, I could say how the second derivative depends on time, because those are equal to each other. They're proportional, at least, not equal. What kind of function satisfies this sort of mathematical situation? In other words, the second derivative of a function is proportional to the negative of that function. So go back to your math class, calculus class. Take two derivatives of some of these and see if you end up with the negative of the same function.